Hi guys, welcome to my new tutorial, and this tutorial is about the oval shape bottom that you might need for bags, for baskets and things like that. I had a previous video which is like a shortcut of this one because I thought maybe most part of you out there are already familiar with like you're not really a beginner in crocheting, but then I noticed that there were a lot of requests and a lot of and some people were saying like that, yeah, it's not step by step, so I thought maybe I should do a video which will include all the rounds and walk you step by step on this oval shape base. Okay, so I hope you enjoy this video, and basically I just wanted to explain to you that I'm using by two cotton, so it's going to be this kind of thickness. So this kind of calculation is for a bit thick, okay? It's not just one yarn, it's two yarns together. So for this I use usually a 3mm hook. So if you're going to use a thinner yarn, probably you're gonna need to do four or five increases, okay? Which means round shape here, you're gonna have to start with four. Okay, so let me explain to you a little bit what's going on with this pattern. So an oval shape is a round shape but divided by two, and then you put in the middle a rectangle. Okay, so here is the half pattern of a round base, and here exactly the same as the other side, okay? But just in the middle you're gonna add stitches to do this rectangle. So this is the logic that goes behind the oval base, right? Because I'm using two yarns together, so for these two yarns, the pattern for the half circle here, it fits very well with three stitches, which means like here, I'm just going to do the increase with three stitches, the same in the other side. But if you are going to use just one yarn, it's thinner, so you probably will have to start here with four stitches, or maybe five. It's just, you have to try, because it depends on how thin your yarn is. And then again here, four, okay? So these stitches here, in my case, three stitches that I added here and three stitches that I started with in this side, these are best basically increases. These are what we call increases, okay? So if I do three stitches here at the first round, that means that I have a pattern with three increases or three sections. So the same in the other side. But if I start with four stitches, that means that I have a pattern with four increases, okay? So I have four sections here. I don't have any more three sections. So I will try to explain that in another video, and I will link it somewhere here. And then, yeah, so this is basically what is the idea. I did in the middle just 10 stitches, because if you need longer, you just have to add more stitches in the middle here. Okay, so basically I calculate like this. Usually I check how long I need the base, and then I will see more or less how many stitches I need here. So if you need this kind of base, this big, like, yeah, like one palm, you just follow these calculations, which is in the middle I have 10 stitches, and then I work one stitch here, one stitch here for in both sides. I calculate plus two stitches because I do increases here, and then also I calculate one stitch because I will turn back. Okay, so basically I will start with 13 stitches if I need this kind of oval base, okay, this big. If you need, for example, a longer one, maybe you start with, you need 20 in the middle, so plus three for the two for the increases and one for the turn, so you are going to start with 23. And if you need longer and longer, you just calculate how many you will need here in the middle, and then just add three. So this will be basically what it is. The pattern starts with one single crochet on each. The first video was with a V-stitch, which I kind of got a few complaints about it, that it's not a V-stitch and V-stitch is another one. And okay, I get it that a V-stitch is another proper stitch, and but for me that is also a V-stitch. It's just not done with a double crochet, but it's a V-stitch because it shows clearly a V there, but it's done with a single crochet. I will call it a V-stitch with a single crochet. So this one, I just did it with a simple single crochet. I didn't use any kind of stitch, okay? Just simple single crochet. So I think it's easy for everybody to understand out there, right? Okay guys, so just press that button of the thumbs up if you like this tutorial, and share, and check my Etsy shop for patterns, and follow me on Instagram and Facebook. And with all these things being said, let's just get into it. I am going to use a 3mm hook, and I'm going to use Catania 100% mesmerized cotton, but by two. Okay, so I'm using these two colors just for fun. I am going to do 13 stitches, which means 10 stitches I will have in the middle, and another 3 stitches I will use. One for making the increases, the semicircle in one side, and another one stitch for this side to make the semicircle, okay, pattern. And also one stitch I need when I turn to do the, to continue and do the single crochet, okay, this way. So for example, if you need in the middle 20 stitches, and then you are going to start with 23, or if you need 30 stitches for the rectangle inside, you're going to need to start with 33 stitches, okay? I much better show you so you can understand, okay? So let's make a slip knot like this. Now I'm going to do 13 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 13, okay? So I will need 2 stitches. I will insert the hook not at the first stitch, not at the second stitch, but at the third stitch here. So why I'm inserting this one? One stitch, of course, I need to turn, to do the turn. One stitch I am going to use for the semicircle pattern, okay? So this is what I was saying previously. If I hope you, it makes sense, okay? So you will leave 2 stitches, and then you will insert the hook at the third stitch. And then we are just going to do a simple single crochet. One, and on the way back, we're going to do 10 single crochet. One, 2, 3, 4, and 10. So I did 10 single crochet. If you are a beginner, I have a tutorial for that on how to do a single crochet, and I will put the link over here so you can check that tutorial. And then let's just continue. So I am left here with one stitch. In this stitch I am going to do the semicircle pattern. Because I have the yarn by two, I have, from my experience, is that the semicircle will have to be with, in the last stitch we are going to do 3 single crochet. 1, 2, and 3. It is good if you use a sign when you start the 3 stitches, so you have an idea of where the semicircle pattern starts. So in this case, this is my half pattern, okay? Because in the other side, I'm just going to do the same. I'm going to do 10 single crochet, and then at the last stitch that we left over here, we're going to do 3 single crochet in one stitch. Okay, so we're just going to repeat the same process for the other side. Whatever yarn you have left like this, you just tuck it in. So now on the way back, I am going to do 10 single crochet. So 1,
too.
Where you have the end of the single crochet of the other side, you just insert the hook, okay? So here is.
Thank you.
This is the pattern for section number one. Section number two, repeat the same pattern. First stitch, two single crochet in one stitch, one and two. Next three stitches, one single crochet on each. One, two, three. Finish section number two and the last section. First stitch, two single crochet in one stitch, one. Next three stitches, one single crochet on each. One, two, and three. This is the pattern for round number five. So we will start the pattern for round number six. Pattern for round number six is going to be first 10 stitches, one single crochet on each. Now we will start the pattern for the semicircle. So we have three sections. So the pattern is going to be first two stitches, one single crochet on each. First stitch, one single crochet. Second stitch, one single crochet. So as you see, at the previous round, I did the increase at the first stitch. Now at this round I am going to do one single crochet on each for the first two stitches, and at the third stitch I am going to do the increase, which means two single crochet in one stitch, one and two, and the last two stitches one single crochet on each. So one single crochet.
Thank you. Thank you. lot of change, been through a lot of pain. Some things are not the same as they were a year ago, but all will be okay. I move on each and every day. The past is where it stays, way back a year ago. I've changed for the better this time. I thought I would never be fine. I strive just to say I'm alright. And for the first time in a long time, I'm alright. I've seen a lot of change, been through a lot of pain. Some things are not the same as they were a year ago, but all will be okay. I move on each and every day. The past is where it stays, way back a year ago. Push all my chips and call all in. I'll bet on myself, you keep stalling. I hear destiny and it's calling. I'll keep my head up high through the downs and lows. And we're all going live, still nobody knows. But I'ma choose what's right and take what comes and goes. And ain't no one in life holding me back no more. I've seen a lot of change, been through a lot of pain. Some things are not the same as they were a year ago, but all will be okay. I move on each and every day. The past is where it stays, way back a year ago. Back a year ago.
And two. Next four stitches, one single crochet on each. One, two, three, and four. Finished section number two, and let's do section number three. First four stitches, one single crochet on each. One, two, three, and four. Fifth stitch, two single crochet in one stitch. One and two in one stitch. Last four stitches, one single crochet on each. One, two, three, and four. Okay, so yeah, so this is the pattern for the half circle. So we did the pattern for the first half. Okay, so the second half is just a repetition of the first half. So I will just tell you the first 10 stitches, one single crochet on each, and then the pattern for the half circle, it's going to be first four stitches, one single crochet on each. Fifth stitch, two single crochet in one stitch. Next four stitches, one single crochet in one stitch. And we will repeat this pattern three times. And this is the pattern for the second half, which is the same as the first half, okay? And I will finish, and then I will meet you once I finish round number 10. Okay guys, so yeah, here it is. I finished round number 10, and if you are planning to have an oval base with this small Then you just start with 10 stitches in the middle and 3 that you need, as I told you the calculations at the beginning of the video. So you can just start with the same calculations, okay? And but if you need to start if you need a longer one, then you have to do here in the middle, you have to do more stitches. So you might start with 15, 20, 25, I don't know, depends on your project and how long you need the oval base, okay? But always calculate 3 more stitches, 2 for the sides for the for this pattern here, and then 1 because you just need to bend over like this and go back, okay? So yeah, this is the pattern, and I hope this pattern is helpful for you, and I hope you like this video, and if so, just give me a thumbs up and share with your friends. And if you are new to my channel, subscribe, and thank you for following me, and check my Etsy shop for patterns and things like that. So thank you for all your support, and see you on my next video.